Thank you for watching this virtual tribute dedicated to my grandfather, Gonzalo Casillas Camblor, and his music. I hope you enjoy hearing these four pieces, and I hope you can join me live on YouTube or on Instagram Live after the program as well. I will be answering questions and talking in more detail about Gonzalo, his works, or the recording process, or the editing process, or anything else that comes up. Before we get into the music, I'd like you to get to know a little bit about Gonzalo. He was born in 1931 in Infiesto, Asturias, Spain. He started as a trumpet player, first playing in bands in Asturias, and then entering the live music scene in Madrid in his 30s. Eventually, he moved back to Asturias and developed a career as a pedagogue in the local conservatory and as a choir and band director for many local ensembles. He also frequently composed and arranged pieces for these ensembles, even through his retirement from the conservatory. Gonzalo was well known and admired as a high caliber and well-rounded musician and as an incredibly kind person, and his musical legacy and really warm character will continue to inspire students, musicians, and everyone who knew him to love music. I hope that this program today will give you a glimpse of what he was like musically and hopefully give you inspiration as well. I would like to mention one last thing before we continue. I will be giving acknowledgments at the end of the program, but up front I wanted to thank the amazingly talented pianist Yuki Mack for recording these selections with me. If you're watching, thank you so much for giving your time and passion to this project. It would not have been possible without you. And without further ado, let's get into the music. As an oral skills teacher at the conservatory, Gonzalo often used a method in his teaching and everyday life of converting any number into notes. In 1981, he converted the winning Christmas lottery number 23786 into a melodic fragment from which he would develop a piece he would entitle El Vals de la Fortuna, or Waltz of Fortune. The first five notes that the violin plays are the numbers 23786, converted into music using Gonzalo's method. So Gonzalo's method is having each number correspond to a note in the C major scale. So 1 is C, 2 is D, 3 is E, and so on. So 23786 is... it ends on an A, so he wanted it to kind of be an A minor thing, but that didn't quite do it, so he changed the D to a D sharp, and that makes it so, you know, still the same number going to the same note, it's still a 2 going to a D, it's just D sharp now, so that centers it on A minor better. And from there, you can hear his, you know, kind of development and variation on the melodic idea. So, you know, for... right, and as you'll hear, you know, he'll keep on adding to this motif. The very last chord from the piano gives a little hint to his jazz background on the trumpet, and also gives a little bit of humor to the playful waltz. I hope you enjoy this recording. Thank you. Thank you. As far as I know, there is little to no knowledge of why Gonzalo composed Es Imposible, or It's Impossible. My guess is that it was written for his wife, Cristina Suarez Martinez. It could be that this is not the case since there's no dedication on the score, but there's no record of this piece outside of Gonzalo's computer, so it's highly unlikely that it was commissioned. In this piece, we see the traits of Gonzalo's compositional style also present in his lyrical style. The text and the music are simple, charming, and heartwarming. But although originally created with lyrics, with this arrangement, with piano and violin, one can hear how Gonzalo's music alone has the ability to tell its story without the aid of words. Gonzalo would often take pre-existing text and compose music to go with it. If it was lyrics from a piece he enjoyed, he would make the music his own by changing several aspects of the piece. Specifically for Milonga Mia, or My Milonga, he altered the melody and the harmonic progression slightly while, you know, still preserving the key center. He also modified the order and the structure of the lyrics and the title. Milonga Mia is based off of Tango de la Muerte, or Tango of Death, by Alberto Novion, most often heard in Carlos Gardel's recording of the piece. Gonzalo's melody, it's a very impassioned melody, sheds tears for the abandoned, desperate protagonist described in the text that sees hope only in music. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. to end the program, I'd like to finish with my favorite of these pieces, Tú me tienes que querer, or You Have to Love Me. The title and also lyrics of this piece may seem a little coercive at first, but the tone is meant to be one similar to, you know, a marriage proposal, you know, on one knee, kind of begging for love in a charming way. Similar to Es Imposible, or It's Impossible, there's no dedication on the score, and there's no record of the piece outside of Gonzalo's computer, so it's also unlikely that it was commissioned. I'd like to think that Tú me tienes que querer was also dedicated to his wife, Cristina. Even without being able to hear the text in this arrangement, I hope you can still get a sense of Gonzalo's warm and loving character through this beautiful music. Thank you so much for tuning into this program. I hope you all gained appreciation for and learned a little bit more about Gonzalo Casillas Cablon and his music through this virtual tribute. I also hope you can join me live on YouTube or on Instagram Live in a few minutes so I can answer your questions about this project or just to say hi and talk about whatever comes up. Before ending the program, I wanted to thank everyone that made this project possible. It's a long list of people, but I'll try to keep it short. Thank you, Marcus, my parents, for always supporting and fostering everything that I've ever done, and for giving me the encouragement and tools that I needed to work on this tribute. Thank you to all my family in Spain, Chris, Nacho, Dani, Gonzalo, Gonzalín, Pedro Miguel, for helping me find invaluable information about the pieces in the program, and Gonzalo's musical history as well. Thank you to my violin and piano teachers, Maria Piabuco, Yuki Mack, Sonia Lee, and Professor Fritz Gerhardt, and to all of my other musical teachers and mentors as well, John Paxton, Richard Lee Sparks, Yaniv Segal, Alvin Rose, John Robertson, Svetlana Sivinskaya, Mariana Cotier-Buco, Jose Antonio Laje, Cristina Casillas, Dani Casillas, and many more too, for teaching me everything that I know about music. And Yuki, thank you so much again for playing with me. It was great. Thank you, Annika Meisel, for teaching me how to video edit. Finally, I know how to do that. And more importantly, for giving me so much musical inspiration ever since I've known you. Thank you to all of my friends, in Oregon and Michigan and Spain and other places too, for showing me what it means to enjoy life and to enjoy all of the people in it too. Last, but certainly not least, thank you to Cristina Aita, the best grandmother in the whole wide world, and Gonzalo Abu, the best grandfather in the world. You would have turned 90 earlier this week, but because of your beautiful music and the way your genuinely kind and loving soul resonated with everyone you met, you'll continue to be remembered in our hearts for another 90 more. Again, thank you everyone for watching this virtual program, and I hope to see you all soon.